ग्रीटिंग्स टू ऑल। वेलकम टू थर्ड डे ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम ऑन इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स हैंड्स ऑन टूल्स दैट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय एंड प्रेजेंट्स बाय स्मार्ट नट्स एंड बोल्ट्स आईओटी स्टार्टअप कंपनी इंडिया। In day two, we have discussed clearly about the introduction to the hardware tools where we can sense, analyze, and act microcontrollers, microactuators. In description of this video, already I have given the day one and day two video links. Those who not watch that links, I request to watch the links. And I given some video regarding to the introduction to the Internet of Things and its various applications. You can watch that links as well in the description of this video. And the agenda of today's training program is software tools to develop an IoT product. We're going to see a programming tool IDE where we can program depending upon our requirement to the microcontrollers after connecting the sensors and actuators to it, how the sensor should sense the value from the environment, and based upon the sensor value, how the actuator should actuate it out. That all things we will program it out, and the program will be dumped inside the microcontroller that we discussed yesterday, Arduino Nano on the NodeMCU board. And we will discuss about in software to design the circuit for the PCB fabrication and etc. That is a EZEDA online circuit designing tool. So after finishing this training program today, what I am expecting from each and every participant and viewer is to get clear idea about how to use an programming tool Arduino IDE and to clear idea about how to design a circuit for the PCB fabrication. This is the outcome I am expressing after completion of this training program today's session. Let me start from the scratch. If you want to go need to work with an Arduino IDE, first you need to install that Arduino IDE. It is a open source. Open source means free is globally available, and we can able to use freely without paying any single rupee. That is the beauty of this Arduino IDE. And with the help of this Arduino IDE, you can able to do any programming in an IoT for any microcontroller. So I am just going to the Google. After going to the Google, I am just clicking on Arduino IDE download for Windows. If you have a Mac or any other operating system, you just click on that. It will navigate to a website www.arduino.ac.com. You just click on the link. So here you can able to see the Arduino IDE where you can able to download it out. Here you can able to see the different versions, Mac version, Windows version, Linux version. So as my system is Windows app, I click on Windows app 8.5 or 10. Once you click on that, it will redirect to the page contribute to the Arduino software or just download. So if you click on contribute and download means you may contribute $3 or etc. Or you just want to download, you just click on the just download. It takes a few minutes to install in your system. Once you download the system, you just click the appropriate buttons and you install on the system. Once you get installed on the system, you go to the search box of Windows and you type here Arduino. You can able to see like this Arduino app. You just click on the open. Taking time to opening the app. Just stay on. As already I have installed the thing. See, a new version of Arduino is available. Would you like to visit the Arduino download page? If you're interested, you click on yes. For now, I am not gonna update, so I click no. Here we go. This is an Arduino IDE. Yes. On the screen, you can able to see two functions. We call this is a sketch, Arduino sketch. We won't call as a program. This is we call as Arduino sketch. You can able to see here two things. One is a setup function, another one is a loop function. So these two are very, very important while coding the things. As I said yesterday, we have a data pins where you can able to connect the sensors and the actuators. So that is a setup function. In the setup function, we will assign the pins. We will set up once what are all the data pins we set for the input and what are the data pins we set for the output. So we will set up once. Whatever you want to do at only once, we will do in the setup function. If you want to do repeatedly action, for example, I want to sense the temperature from an environment continuously. So to sense the temperature, I will use that code in the loop function. So if you want to execute your code once, we will put in the setup function. If you want to execute your code repeatedly, one after the same time, means then we go for the loop. So in a Arduino sketch, we have two functions. One is a setup, one is a loop. In a setup, we will go for the code which we want to execute only once, whereas in the loop we will go for the code which we will execute the code repeatedly. Well, to demonstrate, let me say one thing, how we can assign the pins. I am just going to the file. I click on the new, just click on the file. You can see the examples there. You can able to see the built-in examples in the basics. I am just going the blink. Here is a blink sketch. See, I am having the wired setup. I am using the code here, pin mode. I am setting the mode of the pin. I am setting the LED built-in pin. For any microcontroller, we have a built-in pin. Whereas in Arduino Nano, we have 13 pin as a built-in pin. I am setting that as output. So pin mode, I am setting only once. I am setting the built-in pin as an output. Okay, so when that should be in a loop, what I'm doing, digital write, I'm making the LED built-in pin high for 1 second and I'm making the LED built-in pin low for 1 second. That is the blinking. High means the LED will get glow, the low means the LED will get off, on off, on off. That's how the LED program will blink the LED. This is a blink program. So if you see here, clearly we have a two functions in this sketch. Setup function, I have set the pin mode. If you want to set a pin mode, any input pin means pin mode. What is the pin number? A0 or D0 or D1, D2. And you just set output means you write OUT output. If you are using that pin for the input means you just write input. In X-ray's case, I have taken the alcoholic sensor. I may connect that sensor to the A0 pin. So alcohol sensor is input. So I will write here pin mode A0 comma input, because the A0, I have connected the alcohol sensor to the A0 data pin. Once you connect the A0 data pin, that pin I need to write here A0 comma, that mode is input mode. So pin mode of A0 comma input. So I want to know the output whenever the abnormal changes is occurring in the alcohol sensor. If the person consumed more alcohol, I want to get an alarm. At the time, what I will do, I write pin mode open D0 comma output, because I connected the buzzer pin to the D0. So pin mode A0 comma input is for alcohol sensor, pin mode D0 comma output is for the buzzer. So that's why I have set the input and output pin. When the input and output pin should be there, I will take in the loop continuously. From the alcohol sensor, it will take the input. I will read as a, if it is a connector, as I connected to the analog pin, I will use analog read. Instead of the digital write, what I will use, I am reading from the analog pin, analog data. That's why analog read, I am reading here. Analog read of the pin mode, A0 comma. Analog read of. So now, okay. If of, I will store that analog value in A. If of, A value is greater than 100. What I need to do? Digital write of the pin D0 comma high. Digital read of pin D0 comma high. Else, digital write of D0 comma low. So whenever the alcohol value detected 100, automatically the buzzer will get high. If the value is less than 100, the value get low. This is how we do the programming in alcohol. Very simple thing. We just need to analyze the code and you get it out. We just require the thinking. Let me go for one more built-in example program. Go for examples. Let me check some. Digital. Let me go with blink without delay. Okay. Yeah. Now we see the different sketch here. Blink without delay. So here what we have, here as well we have two functions. One will be the setup, another one will be the loop. See here, setup function. So I want to build LED, just I am taking here pin mode, LED as the output pin. In the loop what I am doing here, I have given the statement, when the LED state is low, when the LED state is high. I am finding here the current millis. I am calculating the millis, interval at which you want to blink the time. Instead of the delay what I am using here, I am calculating the millis, time. So based upon the current milliseconds, it will get automatically the state on or off. So LED state is a variable, high or low, based upon the current milliseconds. How many time I need to get on and how many time I need to get off. So to write a setup program, we take a new sketch, file new, and here I want to set the pin as modes. You can take here pin mode, you can set what type of pin you are trying to use. You want to use the A0, comma, it may be a input. I have set the pin and I want to go for the pin mode. I have set that pin to the D0. So I will go with output. So I have set the input pin and output pin. Now in my case is A0 pin is a moisture sensor and D0 pin is a gate valve sensor. So I have set the input and output. So when the output should get, gate valve sensor should get on. So now what I am doing here, if first I am declaring a variable, I am reading A equal to, I am reading analog, analog read. I am reading here, what I am reading here, analog read, from where I am reading, from A0 pin, so write as A0 pin. So I am reading the value of A0, I am declaring in the A, okay. Now A has what? Moisture level value. Now I am writing the program, if, what I am doing, A value is greater than 300, then what I should get? A value is 300 means, what I need to get? Digital write. What you want to write? In our case, our pin is D0. So what I need to do? High. So the gate valve sensor will get on. So when I need to off, here I want to use one more sensor called level sensor. If the level of the pot I want to make digital write off. D0, comma, low. When I want to make a low, if A, I am taking the other value B, I am taking the other input, this is the moisture level sensor, whereas B is what? B is water level sensor. You can write a comments here. B is water level sensor. D naught is what? Gate valve sensor. Which gate valve? Water gate valve sensor. So clearly, A is what? A is a moisture level sensor. Where I need to know? In soil. In soil, if moisture level is very low, means what will happen? The gate valve should get on. If level sensor is 1, level is reached, means it should get low. Gate valve should get automatically off. So here I need to insulate one more sensor called, what is that? Pin mode off. I will connect to A1. Level sensor as a input. Now done, two sensors. This is for what? This is to detect the moisture level. This to on or off gate valve. And this is to what? This is to sense the level of water. If I reach the level full, automatically the gate valve should get off. This is the application which I discussed in previous classes regarding the automatic watering the plants. So with this code, what we can do? We require three sensors, two sensors and one output. What are the sensor? Moisture level sensor and level sensor. I have connected the two sensors to the pins A0 and A1, and automatically I have done input and output. Whenever I want to require, I can able to switch it on based upon the automation. There is no any human intervention. Based upon the direction of the water level sensor, automatically the gate valve will get on, and the automatically the gate valve will get off. That's it. So this is the way of doing the programming. I have go to the file and I have clicked on the new button, and based upon our requirement I have done the code. After finishing the code, what I need to do? I need to verify it out. The tick mark is available on here, right? You just verify there. Before verifying, you need to save it out. You just save. Automatically the compiling will start here. The verify program will identify any errors is existing in the it will detect. Is there any errors is there? So that if there is any error, means automatically we can able to rectify the errors. Once you rectify the errors, what we need to do? We can able to upload the code. See here, some error is happening here. Automatically in the place of comments, I have used some these things. Okay. Once you compile it out, you can see the arrow mark here, right? That is to upload. Before uploading the program, make sure that you need to copy the things. You need to connect the microcontroller to the program before going to the before uploading. When you can upload the program means when you whenever you connect the code. So first you compile it out. Once you feel that there is no any errors, automatically what you need to do? You need to upload it out. Before uploading is very, very important. As I shown in the yesterday class, with the help of USB, you connect the USB port and upload it out. And after connecting it out, go to the tools. Once you connect the thing, the port will be enabled here. You select the appropriate port that where you connected that USB. Compile it out. After compiling, you connect the microcontroller to our system. Once you connect the system, go to the tools. And here the port, you select the port COM4 or COM3 or COM5 that which you connected to the internet. Once you select the port, you select the board here. Which microcontroller you are connecting? Are you connecting the Arduino Nano? or you are connecting the ESP board. What kind of board you selecting? You select the Arduino board and you select the port. Once you make sure that you need to do these two steps, then only the code will work. The code will be successfully uploaded. If you not do these two things, the code will not uploaded. So make sure that you select the board. What kind of board? Arduino Nano or what? And what kind of port you connected it out. If you want to add any new boards, means go to the board manager. For example, the microcontroller which I shown yesterday. Yesterday's board ESP826. Node MCU is not. Belongs to the Arduino. So we need to add the library for that one. So go to the board manager and you can add here. This is the thing, ESP8266. So you can click install so that you can able to add the board ESP826. So whenever you find the boards apart from the Arduino company, not the boards, if the boards not belong to the Arduino, if other company boards apart from the Arduino boards, you need to install the library for that particular microcontrollers. Whereas yesterday I have used the board Node MCU, that is not belongs to the Arduino. So I need to go for the board manager and I need to install the particular library here, install it out. Once you install that, automatically this will can able to see in the tools. You can able to see this board in the tools and board information. If you search here, there is no any ESP826 here because I have didn't install the board manager. So these things are very, very important. So go to the file, type the code, compile it out by ticking the mark. Once you feel the code is very good, then you connect the system and go to the tools, you enable the port and select the board. After doing this all steps, you click on the upload button. You can see the code is successfully uploaded. This is how we do the programming for any microcontroller. If the microcontroller apart from the Arduino, means we need to go for the board manager and select it out. You can go to the file preferences. Here you can able to give the additional board manager URLs. You can check here. Go to the preferences. Here you can able to see additional board manager URL. Here as well you can able to give the URL. Once you give the URL, then you go to the tools. Then you click on the boards manager. There you can able to find what URL you trying to install it out. As I seen, ESP82. So you can able to see here, you just click on the install, automatically it will get installed. Then you click on the upload button, automatically the code is uploaded. So once the code is uploaded, now automatically that will work without using anything. And you can see here serial monitor. You can do some cool stuff with the help of serial monitor as well. For example, you don't want to use the external display of the sensor values. You can able to display in the serial monitor. So you cut out the sensor values. You want to see what is the value of the sensor, means if you don't want to use external display, you can use the serial monitor here. With the help of serial monitor, you can display the values here and you can be able to do it out. So this is the one type of display, serial monitor. So this is the things we need to remember here. What are the things means? Once again, I'm just repacking. Download the Arduino IDE, go to the file, type the programming, you compile it out, you connect the board, select the port, select the board. If you don't identify the boards, means go to the board manager, you install the thing, then upload it out. Once you upload it out, the code was done. If you want to do the display, if you don't want to use external display, means go to the serial monitor and you can able to display the sensor values. This is about this Arduino IDE. If you watch my YouTube channel, already I have seen you how to blink the LED and how to connect the microcontroller, etc., etc. You can check my YouTube channel for this cool stuff. In future videos as well, I will do more experiments in this one. As this workshop, I am just giving introduction to all the tools to get an idea. So still you have any difficulties in the Arduino, how to use, etc., you can leave as a comments. Those who didn't subscribe to it, subscribe it out. You click on the bell icon so that you will get a notification whenever I do the new video to you. Well, next I go for the circuit designing tool. Now I clear with Arduino. I clear with the hardware what we require, and I clear with the software how to dump the code. Okay. Now if I go for the production, PCB fabrication. Now based upon our requirement, that will work. Now I want to give the printed circuit production. How to design a circuit online means, go to the Google. I am just going to the Google. There you type Easy EDA. You just click on Easy EDA. See, circuit design software. It is free. No need to pay any money. So go to the Easy EDA designer. So you need to log in. You can log in here, register, and you can log in here whenever you require. So if you want to download the circuit, whatever you design, you need to register and you need to log in it out. Register and log in. You can check here. See how it's there. Go to the new project. Let me log in here. I go with my account. Simple login option. Done. I have logged into the Easy EDA with existing Gmail account. Now I am going to the new project. You just give any Arduino project like that. You just give the name of that. You can give the description if you require. You save it out. Yes, this is the space where you can able to put our components and do it out. So you can see the library column here. Some components are already existing. Some components may not exist. At that time, you need to add the libraries. For example, the boards like ESP8266, etc., etc. boards may not be here. In such case, you can go to the library and you can add the libraries. You can check here. Any symbols, whatever you require, you just, I will take as Arduino Nano. Let me check this one. See, I'm having a lot of nanos here. This all I'm having already. You can check it out. Title, what you require, etc., etc. See, with different manufacturer. Same Arduino Nano can be different manufacturers here. So there will be the corresponding thing. You can use it here. Okay, once you get all the symbols, you can see here, Design Manager, Components. See here. As we discussed here, we have different components where you can just drag and drop. You can see ground, you can 1 or 2 or 3 or whatever may be. You can able to see here, right? वेल फॉर एग्जाम्पल ऐसे आई हैव सेट द थिंग राइट, रेजिस्टर, दीज आर रेजिस्टर यू कैन एबल टू पुट हियर, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू यूज एनी कैपेसिटर यू कैन यूज हियर एंड यू कैन डू द ड्राइंग बेस्ड अपॉन यूर रिक्वायरमेंट. सॉरी दिस इज आर्डिनो. See, I have a resistor here. You can able to use it out. You can use depending upon your requirement. Okay. So whatever the component you require, you just click on that. It will come in here, so automatically this will be, see, what are the resistor, you click here. If you want to modify individually, you click on these individual links and you can able to give modify it out. You can see the layers here, what I want to do, how you want to do it out here. Okay, this is how the final thing looked like. You can give company name, whatever may be here. You can design depending upon your requirement. You got right? This is how we will do the circuit design. Once you do the circuit design perfectly, you click on the JLCB PCB. This is the online fabrication company where they will print the PCBs for you online and they will courier to your place. Once you clear the circuit diagram, you can draw here. Not only this ED, easy EDA, you can use any circuit diagram. You can use any circuit development tool. With any circuit development tool, you draw the circuit, you create the jumper file. Once you create the jumper file, you order in the JLBCP, where you can able to do the PCB prototyping and the PCB fabrication. So this Easy EDA is online tool where you can able to draw the circuit. Once you design the circuit, what do you need to do? What you need to do? You create the jumper file here itself. Once you create the jumper file, you go to the JLC PCB, PCB prototype and the PCB fabrication company, where this will do the fabrication online. Due to net problem. Yes, this is the JLC PCB where you can able to order the PCBs. You can take the dimensions, you can choose how many quantity you require, 5 pieces or 10 pieces, and how many layers, thick, etc., etc., you can able to give here. And you will get a quotation. Once you send the jumper file to them, automatically they will courier to the address which you are taking. See here. This is the add your jumper file. So after easy EDA, we will create a circuit diagram here and we will create a jumper file. Once you create a jumper file, you see, you can able to save here, save as, or import as what, export from the, as you want to export as a PDF, XPNG, whatever you can do here. And you can go for the different options here and create the jumper file. Once you create jumper file, you add your jumper file here and give the instructions clearly here, how many layers you want, 1, 2, or how many layers you want and how much quantity you want. See here, how much quantity, design, different design or delivery format, single PCB or panel by JCB, thickness, color, green or red, whatever may be, surface finish, copper. You check the different things here depending upon your requirement. You quote, you save to quote and order now. Automatically they will courier to the different upon our place. You will get within the, they said 2 to 3 times, 2 to 3 days, you may get these things within a week or a 10 days to the place, any place. Okay, this is the software we need to use to develop an IoT product. First thing is how we can able to program based upon our requirement, the sensors and the accuracy should work. And then how you can design a circuit. Once you design the circuit, create a jumper file and upload here to do the PCB fabrication. These two things will be used in the softwares to develop an IoT product. So I hope you can able to do the programming and you can able to create the circuit. With this I have added the software tools that required to develop an IoT product. So any questions you can type in the chat box or you can mail to me. Tomorrow we're gonna see about the cloud to store the data. Now we worked it out. If you want to sense the data from the once we sense the data from the sensor, if you want to store that in the cloud for the to know the analytics, means what kind of cloud tools we need to require, we will see in tomorrow. First day we have seen the introduction, second day we have seen the hardware tools, today is the third day we have seen the software tools, tomorrow we will see the cloud tools, tomorrow is the fourth day. On fifth day we will see the research tool in an IoT, exclusively for the researchers. In fifth day I will see about research tool for the things. So to get updates, you click on the bell icon and subscribe it out. If you like, click on like, otherwise you dislike it out. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow we will discuss about the cloud tools to develop an IoT product. Okay, thank you to all. See you tomorrow at same time. Have a good day.